Stepping into cancer treatment meant learning new words and their meanings. The same applies to clinical trials. Understanding this vocabulary helps to lessen the fear. And because this is cutting-edge medicine, it's important to understand not all trials have the same purpose.
We come out as a medical team and a research team with a document that's called a protocol. This protocol is the Bible of this whole clinical trial. We can't do any more and we can't do any less than it says there.
So the protocol tells us about the background, sort of how we're going to treat patients, what do we do if they have side effects, how we tell certain agencies what happens both if they benefit or if they don't benefit. And in the end, it's a whole plan about how we're going to analyze the data because we want to be able to sort of say, okay, we're treating this many people because if we have this many responders, we can make this statement. So it's a very well thought out plan that sort of lets us move forward so that when we're done with the study, we can report it. Cancer clinical trials come in at least three different phases. The first one is phase one. So these are drugs or combinations of drugs that have not yet been tested in patients with cancer. So these are safety studies. What is the right dose? What is the right drugs? What's the right schedule? So we're trying to sort of fine-tune those aspects of it.
Phase two builds on the knowledge from a phase one study. When it moves to a phase two, we're interested in finding out what the response of the cancer is to that drug at that dose on that schedule.
And phase three is a sort of the last stage. These are drugs that sort of have been proven to be safe and effective. Now the issue is it better than what we used to do or currently do, or could it become the new standard?
Placebo is the word that I think probably causes the most fear and the most concern among patients that hear the word, thinking that I'll either be treated for my cancer with real drugs or I'm going to get a placebo, and that doesn't happen. We need to at least give whatever the standard of care treatment is. So that means for your diagnosis, if the standard of care is treatment A, we have to match or at least give that. Where placebos would most often be used is in phase three studies, where we want to figure out whether or not what we have in this clinical trial treatment, this new drug, is better than what we're already using.
So randomized is just a flip of the coin. So we have two options that we think have equality or equipoise. So we think that sort of either arm would be a reasonable option for the patient. And a computer, an envelope, just flips a coin and says, okay, this patient's going to be assigned to this arm, not that arm. Patients, the doctors, everybody involved on the team do not have any say in that randomization. It really is picked by chance that they get selected for one arm or the other.
Another word that sometimes comes up, which is blinded, that being blind means that the physician and the research nurse don't know which group you're in. They know that you're getting treatment, but if there's an extra treatment, and that is the study drug, they don't know which group you're in.
And that's one of the merits that I think of participating in a clinical trial is that you get a lot of people who are looking after you. On that team is the research nurse. So the research nurse is your navigator, your partner, who sort of knows all the rules, works with the physician team, provider team to sort of make sure that we're following the rules, and is your immediate access to the health system if there's issues related to the treatment that you're on.
In order to really make sure that every patient has the opportunity to participate in a clinical trial, we have to talk to them about the trial. We have to talk to them about whether or not it's a good fit for them. And that means clinically, so that they're safe. And that also means, does it fit in your life? Having access to cutting-edge treatment is only great if it works for your life and your disease.